Hello everyone, this video I am preparing today in continuation of the second chapter of biology of class 10th, and the name of the chapter, as you know, it is control and coordination. We studied many more things in this chapter. Today I will discuss about the endocrine system, their secretions and their functions. Maybe it will take some more time, and by paying attention on your request, the video should be short. I will try to do that. Okay, let's begin the topic. Control and coordination, endocrine glands and their secretion. So first of all, we have to know glands and their types. What are glands? So glands are the collection of a special kind of cell that secrete specific chemicals that show specific action in the body of organism, and that chemical is called hormone. Hormones are also called chemical messengers, and they act on target sites and carried by the blood. Characteristics you studied in the previous video. Let's study about the types. Dear students, glands are of three types. The first type of the gland is exocrine glands. Exocrine glands are those glands which have the duct and they do not secrete their secretion directly into the blood. Okay, so they are having the duct. You can take the example of salivary glands. Okay, salivary gland is an exocrine gland because it do not secrete its secretion directly into the blood. Okay, you can take another example also, like the liver, that is the largest gland of the body. It also secrete its secretion through the duct. You know, the duct is called the bile duct and the secretion is bile. Second type of gland is endocrine gland. Endocrine gland. These glands secrete their secretion direct into the blood. They do not have the duct to transfer their secretions. Okay? You can take example here, like the thyroid gland. Thyroid gland, adrenal gland. Okay, so these are some examples of endocrine glands. The third type of gland is heterocrine. Heterocrine gland. It is the third type. These glands having the property of both exocrine as well as endocrine. Okay, means some of the part of heterocrine glands behaves like exocrine gland, and some of the part of the heterocrine gland behaves like the endocrine gland. So it is called heterocrine gland. Means some of the part secrete its secretion through the duct, and some of the parts secrete secretion directly into the blood. You can take here example, pancreas is the famous example and easy to learn also. The exocrine part of pancreas, exocrine part of pancreas secrete pancreatic juice. Okay, pancreatic juice that helps in the digestion of food. Trypsin, amylase, lipase, these are the secretion of exocrine part of the pancreas. While the endocrine part of the pancreas, endocrine part of pancreas, it secretes the hormones like insulin. You heard about this hormone, glucagon, okay. Actually, the endocrine part of the pancreas is named as the isolates of Langerhans that secrete the this type of secretions that we have like the endocrine gland. Okay, so these are the three types of glands: exocrine glands, endocrine glands, and heterocrine glands. Now these glands secrete their secretion. Here we do not have to study about the exocrine gland. We have to study the endocrine glands because the topic is the endocrine system. Okay, and we will also study about the secretion of pancreas and testes ovaries. Testes ovaries are also the heterocrine type of glands. Okay, dear students, glands in the body of organisms are originates in different embryonic stages, different embryonic origin. So they do not function as an organ system in the body of organism like the digestive system, respiratory system, and many more systems. Still, they perform in a coordinated manner and they are intact with each other. Okay? There are different types of secretions which control the secretion of one another. You can take the example of secretion of hypothalamus stimulate the pituitary gland to secrete some type of secretion, and the secretion of pituitary gland stimulate the endocrine glands to secrete their secretions. Okay, we have in this chapter we study about different types of glands. Like we can take the example are named, that is the hypothalamus. Okay, second is pituitary gland. Pituitary gland. Third, you can take pineal gland. Next is the thyroid gland. Parathyroid gland. Adrenal gland. Thymus. Pancreas. Ovary and testes. So we will study about these glands and their secretion and their action on the body of organisms, especially in human beings. Okay, so let's begin with hypothalamus. Hypothalamus is the gland that's situated at the base of brain. Okay, and it is composed of nervous tissues, and these nervous tissues secretes different types of neuro hormones that stimulate the pituitary gland, and after stimulation of pituitary gland in turn stimulate other glands, endocrine glands, to secrete their secretions. Besides this, hypothalamus directly secretes other hormones also, like the vasopressin, that store in the anterior part of the pituitary gland, and it later secretes whenever the body is required. Okay, so let's study about the hypothalamus and what type of secretion hypothalamus secretes. So first is the thyrotrophin releasing hormone. Thyrotrophin releasing hormone. This hormone secreted by the hypothalamus and it stimulates the pituitary gland to secrete the thyroid stimulating hormone. Thyroid stimulating hormone, and this thyroid stimulating hormone stimulates the thyroid gland. The action is thyroid, target site is thyroid gland. Okay, and now thyroid gland start to secrete its secretion, and you know the famous secretion, that is the thyroxine. Here hypothalamus secretes thyrotropin releasing hormone. This hormone acts on pituitary gland, and what activity will happen there? It stimulate pituitary gland in action of this hormone, secretes the thyroid stimulating hormone. This stimulating hormone stimulates the thyroid gland that start to secretion thyroxine. Okay, now the next hormone secreted by hypothalamus is corticotropic. Adrenocorticotropin. Adrenocorticotropin hormone releasing hormone. Okay, you can take the first word and you will get the short form also. Okay, by first letter. This act stimulate the pituitary gland to secrete the adrenocorticotropic hormone. Adrenocorticotropic hormone, and the target site of this hormone is the adrenal cortex, and this adrenal cortex secretes the secretions that prepare the body to deal in the emergency conditions. Okay, so this is adrenocorticotropin hormone releasing hormone that secreted by hypothalamus. This hormone stimulate adrenal gland, pituitary gland to secrete adrenocorticotropic hormone, and this hormone act on adrenal cortex, and as a result adrenal cortex start its secretion. Okay, now next is the luteinizing hormone release hormone. Luteinizing hormone releasing hormone. Okay, this is the secretion of hypothalamus. It acts on pituitary gland, and pituitary gland also luteinizing stimulating hormone. It start to secrete, and it acts on gonads. It acts on gonads. As you know, gonads are two. In male it is testes, and in female it is ovary. Okay, so this hormone secretes, hypothalamus secretion is luteinizing hormone releasing hormone, and this secretes stimulate pituitary gland to secrete luteinizing hormone that acts on the gonads, that is the ovary and testes. Okay, next is the, you have to keep on note down in notebook. Okay, you can make a table also, which three lines I am writing here, next perhaps it is fourth, that is follicle stimulating हार्मोन, रिलीजिंग हार्मोन, रिलीजिंग हार्मोन. दिस स्टिमुलेट्स द पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड टू रिलीज फॉलिकल स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन. फॉलिकल स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन एंड दिस फॉलिकल स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन एक्ट्स ऑन द अगेन ऑन गोनेट्स. ओके, गोनेट्स, टेस्टिस एंड ओवरी. ओके, तो दिस फॉलिकल स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन एक्ट्स ऑन गोनेट्स एंड ओवरी. द हार्मोन स्टिमुलेटिंग रिलीजिंग हार्मोन इज रिलीज्ड बाय द हाइपोथैलेमस. इट एक्ट्स ऑन पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड. एज अ रिजल्ट पिट्यूटरी स्टार्ट टू सेक्रेट द स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन एंड इट स्टिमुलेट द गोनेट्स टू सेक्रेट द फॉलिकल हार्मोन्स. ओके, नाउ द अनदर इज द ग्रोथ हार्मोन. Another is the growth hormone releasing hormone. Growth hormone releasing hormone secreted by hypothalamus. Okay, and this again very simple to learn. Very simple to learn. Releasing hormone, it is the extension of hypothalamus and here we can do the stimulating and inhibiting. Okay, in pituitary gland it stimulate growth stimulating hormone secreted by pituitary gland and it acts on most of the tissues of the body. Most of the tissues, because growth is not the result of any part, it is the growth of body as a whole. So most of the tissue will have to grow and the organism will grow as a whole. Okay, so growth hormone releasing hormone is released by the hypothalamus. This hormone stimulates pituitary gland to secrete growth stimulating hormone. It acts on the most of the body tissues and as a result the body will grow. Similarly here you can inhibiting hormone also, growth hormones, if excess growth hormone stimulating hormone will secreted, the body will grow abnormally. So it need to control the growth also, in that why the body will be in a proper proportion. So it will also releasing inhibiting hormone. Okay, it send the signals to secrete the inhibiting hormone and here growth inhibiting hormone is secreted by pituitary gland. Okay, inhibiting hormone secreted by the pituitary gland that act on most of the tissues of the body and as a result the growth either inhibit or stimulate depending on the type of hormone secreted by the hypothalamus. Okay, now prolactin prolactin stimulating releasing hormone, it acts on pituitary gland to secrete prolactin stimulating hormone. And it acts on the mammary gland. It acts on mammary gland. M A double M ARY, mammary gland. And as a result, mammary gland secreted secretion. Similarly, this hormone in case of releasing inhibiting hormone. Okay, so you can add one more number, 7, and here we can write inhibiting hormone, and it prolactin inhibiting hormone will secreted in inhibiting hormone secreted by this, and that acts on the mammary gland. There are other hormones also, just for example melanocytes that acts on the skin cells, and that is not for the human beings, that for the organisms like the fish. Okay, so hypothalamus stimulate pituitary gland, and pituitary gland control the secretion of rest of the endocrine glands. That's why often pituitary glands is called master gland, because it controls all the endocrine glands, and pituitary gland itself controlled by the hypothalamus that is situated at the base of brain. Your work is to, whatever you seen today, whatever I spoken today, you have to write this in copy by making chart table. Like you can make 3 columns in the table. Okay, in this way, 3 tables. One is the secretion of hypothalamus. Okay, in one, secretion of hypothalamus. Thalamus. In second, you can write the action, है ना, secretion of pituitary gland. You can write secretion of pituitary gland, and in third column you can write the target sites. Okay, so endocrine glands are the target sites where they, these hormones are acting and bring change in the body. The secretion of hormone is very important to maintain the homeostasis in the body. Okay, this all activity is to maintain the equilibrium, homeostasis. Okay, this is all for today. In next video, I will talk about the pituitary gland. Till then, see the video again and again, watch it again and again, observe it again, and try to learn and build the concept. Thank you. Have a nice day. Stay home. Remain safe. Bye-bye.